Atoms might seem insignificant, but these microscopic building blocks hold an immense potential for energy that could provide the answer to one of humanity's biggest challenges: keeping the lights on without f***ing up the planet. The trouble is, harnessing atomic energy is a little tricky, and getting it wrong can be unpleasant. So let's take a look at the wonders of nuclear power. Although humans are literally made of atoms, no one knew they existed until ancient Greek philosophers Leucippus and Democritus came up with the concept around 430 BC. But without proof, nearly everyone ignored them. By the 1900s, the existence of atoms was finally proven. And in 1938, dynamic German duo Otto Hahn and Fritz Strassmann, with help from the often overlooked Lisa Meitner, figured out how to split atoms to unleash an enormous amount of energy, a process called nuclear fission. Naturally, the first things human did was build a bomb. But after the dust settled, someone realized that atomic energy could also power toasters, televisions, and table lamps. And nuclear power was born. But how exactly can atomic energy be released? Well, first you need the right kind of atom. Heavy, radioactive atoms, like uranium-235, are the easiest to split due to their instability. By packing them into fuel rods, inserting them in a nuclear reactor, and bombarding them with subatomic particles called neutrons, the atoms can be forced to break apart, releasing even more neutrons, which, like a game of atomic dominoes, smash into other uranium atoms, causing a chain reaction. This creates heat that turns water into steam, which spins turbines to generate electricity, without burning or releasing any carbon. Compared to a kilogram of coal, a kilogram of uranium generates over 150,000 times more energy. And since uranium is pretty common on Earth, this low-carbon energy source could last for centuries. By displacing fossil fuels, it's already prevented the release of almost 70 billion tons of carbon dioxide over the last 50 years, more CO2 than Japan or India have ever emitted. But perhaps its biggest strength is its continuous reliability, which means it could solve the biggest challenge facing wind and solar power: the intermittency problem. Since wind and solar depend on weather, they can't always provide power when needed. So until humans work out how to store enough wind and solar energy for use on those cloudy, windless days, nuclear could be an important source of consistent baseload power that reduces reliance on fossil fuels. It already accounts for 9% of global electricity production. But why don't humans use it more? Well, let's address the elephant in the room. Three Mile Island, Chernobyl, Fukushima. These nuclear accidents weren't exactly great for PR. They all involved failures in cooling the reactor cores and human error. An overheated core can melt down, releasing dangerous levels of radiation that can linger for decades. Which brings us on to another major drawback: nuclear waste. When uranium atoms split, they don't just release energy, they create incredibly radioactive fission products like cesium-137 and strontium-90 that persist for decades and leave behind spent fuel that remains radioactive for millennia. Nuclear waste can also be reprocessed to extract plutonium to make nuclear weapons, creating risks of nuclear proliferation as more and more countries gain the means to make a bomb. And then there's the cost. Large nuclear power plants are slow and expensive to build, with construction sometimes taking decades and costing tens of billions of dollars, far more than wind, solar, or even fossil fuels. Worse, building new power plants has become more expensive over recent decades, while sources like wind and solar have become much cheaper. So, why do humans bother with nuclear power at all? Well, surprisingly, nuclear power is actually much safer than fossil fuels, which pump out toxic air pollution that kills millions of people a year. Far more than nuclear has killed in its entire history. In fact, nuclear power ranks as the second safest energy source after solar. But what about the problem of nuclear waste? Well, historically, humans have stored it in large concrete containers or buried it in underground vaults to prevent leaks. And deep geological repositories that could safely store waste for millennia are being built underground in Finland, Sweden, and France. So, while waste is a challenge, it can be overcome, and the total waste produced is small compared to the energy generated. As for that pesky plutonium, it's now very difficult to extract weapons-grade material from the waste of modern reactors, leaving very little opportunity for mischief. Which leaves us with the final problem, the cost. But while power plants are expensive to build, once operational, they usually run relatively cheaply for 60 to 80 years, far longer than wind and solar installations, which have a lifespan of only 20 to 30 years. Nuclear plants can also plug straight into existing electrical grids, whereas wind and solar require storage and transmission upgrades due to their intermittency. Advanced reactor designs like molten salt reactors can further improve safety and efficiency. By using liquid fuels, they can operate with higher thermal efficiency at lower pressures. They also have better fail-safe mechanisms. If the fuel overheats, it melts a plug and the fuel automatically gets dumped to cool off. Tragedy averted. And there's growing excitement around small modular reactors, which are built in factories off-site and could cut upfront costs as well as speed up construction. Tech giants are already exploring their use to power their data centers, as well as shipping companies, to power the container ships of the future. So, the big question. Should humans use nuclear energy? Well, no energy source is perfect, and nuclear fission definitely has its drawbacks, mainly that it's pricey and can take decades to build. Meanwhile, wind and solar farms are quicker and cheaper to set up, and their costs, along with those of battery storage, are dropping fast and should keep falling over the next decades. So, by the time new nuclear plants or even modular reactors come online, faster-moving tech, like wind and solar, supported by battery storage, may have already taken the spotlight, potentially making nuclear feel, well, a bit late to the party. But for now, nuclear is one of the few low-carbon options that can deliver continuous, safe, and reliable power. So, if humans are serious about cutting their carbon, at the very least, keeping existing nuclear plants running isn't just smart risk management, it's essential. And whether new nuclear tech becomes cost-effective in time, or energy storage solutions make renewables the go-to answer, one thing is clear, the race is on. Please, spread the word about climate change solutions by sharing this video and like and subscribe if you would like to see more. Thank you.